Back in the early days of Warzone, shotguns used to be a lot better. Pump actions could one-shot, and the Origin 12 was able to two-shot. Then the nerf happened, and it turned into a three-shot kill for the Origin, and everybody was on to the next best thing for each season, like the R90 with Dragon's Breath, or the Street Sweeper in the Jack 12. But I'm here to tell you today that the Origin is still awesome, and you do not need to sleep on it anymore. Its most comparable counterpart is the Gallo, or the Gallo, which I've compared the two in another video before, but today I want to take a look at just the Origin and see why I think it's still such a great shotgun that's slept on, so let's get into it. The Origin, like the other spammy shotguns, has a max damage range and then a 3-shot kill range. The max damage range for the Origin was at about 4.1 meters, and its 3-shot kill potential is up to about 7.6. These numbers are eerily similar to the Gallo, but they're actually shorter. The Gallo has a 4.5 max damage range and then an 8.1 meter 3-shot kill, so right off the bat, the Gallo may seem better just because of the range, and it is in that sense. The Origin was never really known for that. The fire rate is basically identical at about 232 rounds per minute, so both of them have roughly a 517 millisecond time to kill, which is pretty good. When it comes to attachments, the Origin gets a beefy boost to range from the Impaler Barrel, and adding the choke to that takes it up even more, but even then, you still can't compare the Origin's max 3-shot kill range of 9.1 meters to the Gallo's 10 meters at least. The Gallo is also faster when it comes to movement speed, and we're talking roughly 5% here, which is a good bit, and you can tell the difference pretty easily between the two when you use them. The Cold War guns are just known for that mobility, and the Origin is a bit of a letdown in that department, comparatively speaking. So it probably sounds like another video already, crapping on the Origin and talking up the Gallo, but that's gonna stop now. What's the biggest thing holding back the Gallo? It's that damn reload. Well, guess what? With the Origin, you can reload a whole magazine. Oh my god, yes. That means faster reloads, which means getting in the action faster. After playing the Gallo for so long and going back to this standard magazine type of attachment, oh my god, it's so good, and you feel like because of it, you've kind of learned how to adapt to that slow reload, and it's made you a better player because of how you handle engagements. With the Origin, you can use a 12 or 25 round drum mag, which I prefer the 12 round because it only hurts movement speed by 1% roughly, and the 25 round drum mag is much worse for that, and it slows you down too much in my opinion, but yeah, it's still pretty freaking awesome. Yeah, it's fun with the spray and pray aspect of it as well, but 12 is good enough amount of ammo for me, and just being able to reload so efficiently now is such a godsend compared to the Gallo and the Street Sweeper. So magazines are a huge plus, but the Origin has also another secret weapon, and that's the sprint to fire speed. The Gallo sprint to fire speed is roughly on par with the Origin, about 17 to 18 frames with the base guns. Now when you add the fastest attachments to boost sprint to fire speed, the Gallo with the no stock goes down to about 12 frames or 200 milliseconds, whereas the Origin with its 5 milliwatt laser and stippled grip tape can get down to about 9 frames, which is about 150 milliseconds. This is really fast, and it's so noticeable when you use it. It feels a lot more snappy than the Cold War shotguns do, which for aggressive players can be an absolute godsend. You'll be able to pull up your gun much quicker than other players, which that small difference in milliseconds can make a big difference in some occasions. Even with just the 5 milliwatt laser, you have a better sprint to fire speed than the Gallo. So it's a great attachment to use, and you can swap out the stippled grip for another attachment if you'd like. In terms of good ranged attachments, the Impaler, as I said, is the best for range, which gives it about a 17% boost, and the Precision Barrel gives us about 9%. But you don't get that movement speed penalty, which is also really nice. I usually opt for the Impaler Barrel because despite it being a bit slower with movement speed and aim down sight speed, I like the range boost and the pellet tightness that it gives you, especially when you use it with the choke. As a reference, here is the Gallo's aim down sights spread about 5 meters away from the wall, and the other group of pellets is from the Origin with the Impaler Barrel. The spread is pretty nice for when you're a bit further out and you really want to hit those 3-shot kills. It makes it a bit more consistent, so long as you're consistent with shot placement, and no, the choke on the Cold War shotguns doesn't seem to do anything to spread. I don't think it actually works as intended, and if it does, then it's a minuscule amount, so I don't really recommend using it. The Precision Barrel is a good barrel as well since it gives you range, but it doesn't hurt movement speed, so if you want to remain as mobile as possible, then just use that one. So now let's check out a good class setup. This will work in just about any game mode because of that magazine available to us now. I like to use the Impaler Barrel and the Choke. Not only does this give us the most range of all of the attachments, but it helps pellet spread well enough. You could use the Monolithic Suppressor, which gives you just about the same amount of extra range as the Choke, roughly 5%, but you don't get tightness for pellets, but you do get suppression at the cost of a more painful aim down sights penalty from it. The 5mW laser is basically an essential attachment for me all the time because it makes your hipfire really good and it helps our sprint to fire speed by a damn good bit. The no stock attachment is also great as it offsets the heavy barrel and the 12-round mag, which, by the way, the next attachment is the 12-round mag. This should work pretty well in solos, duos, trios, and yeah, it can even work in quads. But if you want to go all out and just spam to your heart's content, in quads specifically, use the 25-round drum mag. There's something about having that huge amount of ammo at your disposal that really works wonders in engagements against multiple people. Even if I've only shot 3 times, I still end up reloading out of habit and it really does get me killed. So the 25-round drum mag can be really nice at times, but overall I just prefer the 12. Also, if you want an insanely fast sprint out time, use the stippled grip tape instead of the choke. I find it already has a good sprint out time with just a 5mW laser, but if you want it to be even better, just swap out those two attachments. Overall, I think the Origin has been out of the meta long enough that now it's considered to be a sleeper shotgun to me. Yes, we do have the slug version of this gun, which is insane. It's in a world of its own along with the Jack 12 with slugs, as with the other slug shotguns, but really, they're really difficult to use, so a lot of people probably won't gravitate towards using them because they're just not as forgiving and they're really difficult to use well. The Street Sweeper, the Gallo, and the Jack 12 have kind of overtaken the spotlight as of the last few months, ever since the Origin 12 got nerfed, because once people hear nerf in their gun, then they tend to avoid it for a good bit. So what we want to do is let's get this bad boy back in here, let's get people using it again, or maybe not. I feel like maybe some people are probably going to be mad at me for saying that because it's annoying, but I think this is sort of the poor man's Gallo, because the Gallo, it's a bit more unforgiving, mostly because of that reload time. Yes, it does have the power and the speed, but man, that reload, it's so bad sometimes, and it really does get you killed at the worst times, especially in trios and quads. But at the end of the day, I think that the Origin is just straight up a lot more forgiving to use than the Gallo, mostly because of the reload speed. So if you're willing to trade that power and the range that the Gallo has for just a bit more ease of use and that faster sprint out time, the Origin 12 will not disappoint you, and I think that we need to bring this bad boy back. But that's just about gonna do it for this video, and I wanna know, what do you guys think? Do you think this is still kind of a sleeper shotgun? Do you think I'm kind of overhyping this and that you should really just stick to the Gallo? And with all that being said, I wanna see you guys in the next video.